Hello students, today we'll cover another poem from your class 10 syllabus from your book First Flight, and the name of the poem is A Tiger in the Zoo, written by Leslie Norris. In this particular video, we'll be covering the introduction of the poem, the stanza-wise explanation of the poem, the main word meanings of the poem, the poetic devices in each stanza, and the theme of the poem. Now, coming to the introduction of the poem is written by Leslie Norris, and she explains the agony and helplessness of a caged tiger that lives in a zoo. The poet contrasts the life of a tiger when it is in its natural habitat and when it is imprisoned in a zoo. He explains what his life would be if he had been a free animal. The poet has tried to explain about the condition of animals that are caged by human beings for their own fun. Now, coming to the explanation, the first stanza, I'll read it out and then I'll be discussing the word meanings followed by the meaning, the explanation. He stalks in his vivid stripes, the few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. Now, he here stands for the tiger. Now, he stalks. Stalks means he follows it. And pads, pads means the paws of the tiger. Rage, rage means the anger. The poet says the tiger that is confined in the zoo moves around in the cage under his bright colored skin. He further says that the tiger can only take a few steps because the cage is small and it is not easy to move in it. One cannot hear his footsteps because he has very soft feet like velvet, because of which there is no sound of the tiger's footsteps. The tiger tries to control his anger by quietly walking in a limited area of his cage. He is also angry because he is not free and is caged. Now, coming to the poetic devices in the first stanza, he stalks in vivid stripes, the few steps of his cage. The first line continues in the second line as well, and there is no punctuation mark denoting that the line is ending. So that is why the poetic device that has been used is enjambment. The next poetic device is pads of velvet, which is a metaphor. The tiger's paws are compared with velvet. So when the care is a comparison and when there is no usage of as or like, so it is a metaphor. Coming to the other poetic device, quiet rage. Quiet means sitting still, not making noise. And rage means angry, ferociousness, having lot of fiery temper. So both these are opposites. So the poetic device used is oxymoron. Coming to the second stanza, he should be lurking in shadow, sliding through the long grass near the water hole where the plump deer pass. Now, lurking means to be hidden in order to wait for your prey. The poet says that had the tiger been free, he would have hidden himself behind the long grass near the water body so that he could easily catch a deer in order to have it as its food. Now, plump means fat, so he would have chased a plump deer. So basically, the poet wants to say that the actual life of a tiger is to live in the natural habitat in the jungle where he could catch his prey and eat it. He would relish his hunt as he likes to be independent and be his own boss. But the tiger in the cage cannot do so as he is imprisoned, almost like imprisoned in the cage. So plump, purr. So two sounds have been repeated. So the poetic device used is alliteration. Sliding through long grass near the water hole where the plump deer pass. So the same line continues in the second, third, fourth line, and there's no punctuation mark in between, so the poetic device uses enjambment. Coming to the third stanza, he should be snarling around horses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. Now, snarling means warning sounds made by animals. Baring means uncovering, showing. Fangs are the sharp teeth of animals. So the poet here says that if the tiger would have been free, he would have snarled around the houses, showing his presence located on and those houses which are located at the outskirts of the forest. He would have terrorized people with his sharp teeth and claws. This would have created a fear among the people living in the villages. Now, coming to the poetic devices, snarling is a sound made. Whenever there is a sound made, like a bee's buzz or a snake's hiss, all these sounds, whenever they are being used in any poem, the poetic device used is onomatopoeia. Now, he should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. Same thing, first line continuing in the second. So, the poetic device used is enjambment. Now, coming to the next stanza, but he is locked in a concrete cell. His strength behind the bars, talking to the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Now, concrete means the building material made of bricks, cement, sand, gravel, and water. Basically, rodi patha, which I use to make any sort of a building, any structure as such. So now the poet compares the what is the present scenario of the tiger. Now the poet comes to the reality of the tiger that is inside the cage. He says that the tiger is confined in a strong cell which is made of strong building material. He further says that as the tiger is behind the bars, so his ferociousness is also behind the bars. He just talks in the cage. He never tries to terrorize the visitors because his power is restricted by the cage. Therefore, he never tries to terrorize the visitors as he cannot actually make them get scared because he doesn't, his powers are restricted. He is confined into the walls of the cage. Now, behind bars, burr burr sound is repeated. Whenever the sound is repeated, I told you, it is alliteration. Now, coming to the last stanza, he hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Now, patrolling means to guard, to vigil, keep an eye on. The poet says that in the night, the tiger hears the sounds of the patrolling cars. Patrolling cars are the vehicles of the police which are used to guard at night. So in the night, the tiger hears the sounds of these cars. He then stares at the shining stars with his glimmering eyes. The poet wants to say that the tiger is sad and as he is confined to the cage, so he cannot do anything. Therefore, he stares at the stars in the night and tries to divert his thoughts towards them. And stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Is the same line has been continuing from the third line to the fourth line. So it is enjambment. He hears is her sound being repeated. So it is alliteration. Now coming to the message, what message the poet wants to give. Through this poem, the poet Leslie Norris tries to convey that just like humans, animals too long for freedom and do not like being caged. For instance, the tiger in this poem longs to be in the jungle and he looks longingly at the shining stars in the sky. By looking at the stars, the tiger hopes to be with nature someday. Just like we humans, after working hard in this modern world, look up to nature for comfort and peace of mind. We also learn that one should not be kept away from its natural surroundings, as doing so would hamper the growth of his character. Now, you can very well imagine, now, since this is COVID time going on, so all of us are being kept under lockdown. We are not allowed to move out at all. So you can just imagine how these animals used to feel when they are also forced to being caged just because of your pressure, just because you want to see them, you cage these animals. Similarly, you can imagine once how we are facing at this point of time when we are forced to sit in our homes, when our freedom is curtailed. So you can just imagine the poet is actually portraying the present scenario. I hope you've understood this particular poem. Any problems, you are free to contact me on my email ID. Now, if you like this video, please like, share, subscribe to it. Thank you. Happy reading.